Reporting outside Hoboken City Hall this evening, where the City Council took up two important issues that have been ongoing here in the Miles Square City. First, it voted on a resolution authorizing the execution of the City of Hoboken settlement agreement with Shipyard Associates, the developer that wanted to build two 11-story residential towers along the waterfront. The council voted 7-0 on that agenda item, with Councilwoman Tiffany Fisher recusing herself from that vote. And then it voted 8-0 on the first ordinance reading to use eminent domain to reclaim the Union Dry Dock property from New York Waterway.
Let's get this project done. Let's connect our waterfront. Let's save our waterfront. And let's make Hoboken a more beautiful, amazing community with an arts program and a connected waterfront than we already have. So thank you so much for coming out, everybody.
Certainly, this step of moving forward to try to effectuate this deal, I think, is a positive move, and I'm in support of it. Thank you.
The surface, it's a good deal. I think it's a good start. As one of the council members had mentioned, though, there's still a lot of work to be done. There's a lot of work to ensure that this is a fair and balanced deal for the city as well as the property owner.
But again, this is just a start, and we have to look at what our next steps are in terms of what the details, what the final deal looks like, and make sure that everyone, both the southern part of Hoboken, which Councilman DeFusco and I represent, and the northern and central parts of Hoboken, all make out on this deal as well. So I'm looking forward to supporting this tonight and looking forward to working with this in the future as well. Thank you.
This is the beginning of a process, and one of my key questions was how this would interact with the potential ongoing litigation with the Supreme Court having granted cert. And so we do continue to have the ability to keep an eye on that while engaging in this negotiation. So this is really just a starting point, but I'm very grateful for all the support of the community for coming out, especially on a night like this, but for the ongoing work of organizations like Fund for a Better Waterfront, and I'm committed to ensuring that we continue to keep the waterfront for all of the residents of Hoboken. Thank you very much.
The most powerful thing that this council can do to help him work across the table from New York Waterway is to grant him the right to exercise eminent domain so they'll take him seriously and we can negotiate a fair price and get them out of there and they can work and do their ferry service at the PATH station where there's already ferry docks. You look at our historic train station, it says ferries to New York on one side. There have always been ferries coming and going from that station. Why not do it there? Thank you for your time.
Ordinance for introduction. An ordinance of the City of Hoboken, New Jersey, authorizing the acquisition by purchase or condemnation of real property located at 901 Sinatra Drive, also known as Block 259, Lot 1, Hoboken, New Jersey, now owned by Port Imperial Marine Facility, LLC.
Please call the vote, Mr. Perino.
Mr. Cunningham?
Aye.
Mr. Fusco?
Yes.
Mr. Doyle?
Aye.
Mrs. Falco?
Yes.
Fisher?
Yes.
Mr. Jabour?
Yes.
Mr. Ramos?
Aye.
President Gentino?
Yes.
Mark Busanich reporting in the Miles Square City for Hudson County View, the eye of the community.